What's up, guys? Here we are on a Truck and Talk Thursday. I'm in the P389. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna start this up for you. It's in neutral. But let's get out. Well, actually, we need to throw some lights on here. Let's get out of it and show you. I'm gonna put it in neutral while it's started and show you what this baby looks like. So, there it is, 389, bit of a show truck. We're taking machine parts today, so. Let's go here. And I'm gonna throw it in the fourth, which would actually be, so here's first, that's lower. There's second, low. Third is one low. Fourth is one high. And how do I get out of this place? Yeah, probably that way. Now, forgive me. It's been a while since I've been in this truck. There we go. I had a driver the other day said that Peterbilts were smooth running trucks, especially the 579. This is the 389. To me, this is a real old school original truck, man. Beautiful sounding truck. Handles so nice. I'm enjoying driving this for the little time that I have it. Alright, I'm gonna check on out here. Nobody coming there. Nobody coming that way either. Alright. And we're stuck. Don't worry, I'll get us out though. So, I'm sure you guys have heard by now about the main story, the topic of this video. There's a self-driving truck out there called Auto. And it's made its first run. Now, it's not a Peterbilt, it's a Volvo. But it was doing mostly highway driving. And it was driving beer. Now, for me, I find that pretty awesome. And I'm sure you guys were wondering what my opinion was on it. Now, I find it kind of awesome. Because even though it's a truck that's driving itself, it still gives, it might lead to something for me down the road. You know, maybe, possibly I could get a bit of a license, some type of license deal, and end up getting the ability to drive one of these trucks in the real world, which would be nice. But as it stands right now, I can't get a commercial CDL license. There might be a little leeway for me to get a regular driving license, but I still need to go through that, because I know you guys keep telling me, you know, go for your dreams. You know, if it's really something you want to do, go for it. So that's what I'm trying to head for. So, that would be awesome. I love the fact that this truck was actually successful in its trip going to... it was actually going from a Budweiser plant, I believe, to another Budweiser plant. Now, because the technology is so new, they only used it for highway driving. We're in Vegas. There's the casinos. They only used it for highway driving. Which, I don't blame them for that. You know, it's new. You want to try to have as little technical issues as possible. You want it in as manipulatable or the least varying situations you can. So, they had chase cars, so cars that were in front of this truck, and then they had following cars, cars that were in the back of the truck. So, completely understandable. Now, it's not happening for a while that they'll start putting these type of computering, monitoring systems, driving systems in these trucks. So none of you guys who drive professionally really need to worry about it. However, it would just be awesome for somebody like me who cannot drive under the means right now, legally, cannot drive. But still, you know, it provides hope. It provides kind of like something to look forward to in the future. So. So that's fourth high. Five low. High. I'm gonna wait. I'm gonna kind of wind it out a little bit here. Sixth low. That's perfect. But no, I mean, you know, a totally autonomous self-driving truck, semi-truck, to me, that's the bee's knees. That's awesome. Provides hope. I mean, when I first heard about that they had this program coming out with self-driving trucks, you know, I thought it was never going to get off the ground. Now that they've already got, you know, a test, that's awesome. Now, a lot of people don't share my opinion, aren't happy that they have a truck, a self-driving truck out there. You know, people are still curious about what can it do and what can it not do. You know, what happens when it gets into, like, a situation like inclement weather, when there's, like, snow on the ground or rain. You know, skidding, what if a car comes and cuts it off? There's a lot of questions that are still raised that people don't really have answers for quite yet. But still, that's something that they're going to probably work through. I mean, you know, there was a lot of issues that were brought up when cars were getting automatic transmissions. When I was talking about, you know, the first car video, you guys kind of brought up about how, well, no, I wouldn't recommend giving a teenager a manual car, trying to teach them how to drive a manual car for their first car. So, you know, when the automatic transmission came out, there were a lot of people who were still very suspicious, a little questioning of how well could that do. So, I mean, you know, like everything, you gotta take it with a grain of salt. The technology is there, it's been tested, but not thoroughly tested yet. But it's something for me to look forward to. Now, am I ungrateful, you know, that I actually have a simulator to drive? I'm not ungrateful, but do I want more? Yeah, and that's just in our nature, you know, we always will want to do more. So far, I'm really content with this. I'm really happy. I mean, this brings me so much joy. I just have a crap day. I hop in the seat, hop behind the wheel. To me, this is about as close as I'm going to get to driving right now. And I enjoy it. I mean, I don't take it for granted at all. So. I know it's nothing like driving a real semi-truck or a car at that point. You know, I'm not really shifting gears. It's just simulated and all, but still. It's close enough to me that it feels so much like driving. You know, it's the only thing I know. But that self-driving truck, I mean, they also have self-driving cars out there that are available. Well, not available commercially, but coming out. You know, Cadillac has one. Google has one. Google's, like, the main people behind the self-driving car. The only thing is, the thing I don't like about the self-driving cars, you know, you gotta use, like, GPS and put in a destined route. You can't make, like, spur-of-the-moment decisions with it. The car will drive itself. Which is something that... yeah, it's cool. It's great. It helps serve maybe 98% of the people. But for me, I'm that type of guy. You know, I was always spontaneous before I really had to start doing things for myself. You know, I'm not really the type of guy who wants to sit about a week in advance, schedule things out. If I want to go somewhere, I want to go somewhere. Now with GPS, that helps, but you know, if I want to, if I'm going to a store that I just searched, and I found out there's one in my area, and then I want to go, you know, say I'm cruising by and I see a store on the left, I'm not going to have time while the car's driving itself to program in. Or I'm not even really going to know this street address for the GPS to know where I want to go. You know, that's the one thing I would want, is just kind of like the independence, the total independence that the quote-unquote normal people have, the normal drivers. So, but don't get me wrong, it's still something cool, it's still something that I am looking into. You know, self-driving car, possibly maybe getting a restricted license is something that I'm looking into, but there's a lot of things I need to consider. And it's a decent way away from me. You know, I can't really say anything. There's still a lot of stuff. There's still a lot of variables to be considered, but still, what are your guys' opinions about this, auto, the self-driving truck? I mean, you know, if you don't share the same opinion I do, feel free to let me know in the comments. Just do it respectfully. Which, I'm pretty sure I don't need to tell any of you guys to do that. I'm pretty sure y'all know what goes and what doesn't when it comes to me. But I just, when I first heard of this story about a week ago, I was like, man, that, oh, sweet. I can't wait for that to actually be true and for companies to start having these self-driving trucks. Now, a lot of people are claiming that it will ruin the trucking industry, which I don't really see how. I mean, you're going to have less drivers, but for people who really want to have like high-value cargo, they're going to want some human intervention there. Like, I'm sure you guys all know there's a few stories, there's urban legends and myths about trucks full of cargo getting stolen and not being reported stolen and never being found. I know it was probably a greater chance back in like the late 70s, early 80s, maybe even clear up to the 90s because of like mafia involvement and the lack of GPSs and how expensive GPS tracking devices were in those times. But still, you know, I know the technology, again, like in the 90s, you know, only rich people had cars with GPS or, you know, government agencies, and it was people who were really high up in the career field had tracked cars that were GPS navigationally tracked. So I'm figuring that basically because the technology is there, it's probably expensive to retrofit a semi-truck. Like, you know, this 389 here that I'm driving probably would be expensive to retrofit with a self-driving unit, self-driving computer. So of course a lot of companies probably aren't going to want to go for that. But still, there's, you never know, there's always the occasional oddball, as I say it, the occasional outlier, as statistics will tell you, that somebody will actually see this for what it really is, how well that these trucks can drive themselves, and actually put in that technology and allow driver interference, driver interface, so that you would have kind of a hybrid of the truck driving itself and a driver driving the truck. So now, guys, I'm gonna do something really crazy here, because I heard my driver talking about, one of my bus drivers was telling me how to double clutch it. Alright, can't double clutch then. Not in this truck. What he was saying, the double clutch is, you throw your truck in the neutral, you hit the clutch, you throw the truck in the neutral, you rev it out, and then you throw the truck up, you shift it without touching the clutch. So that doesn't work. And also too, another thing is, a lot of the semi-truck world, from what I've read on forums, they don't really approve of the people who have the automatic trucks. Quite a few people have said, and I've seen this comment, you don't want somebody who can't drive a stick to be driving a semi-truck. And that's kind of what pushed me into learning how to drive a manual with the simulator, you know? Before learning how to shift and where my shifting positions were, like where gears were, I actually did start out with an automatic semi-truck, and then, started out with an automatic semi-truck, and then used one where you had to use the clutch, and then you push up to shift up in the gear, or you push down to shift into lower gear. And after a while, I got comfortable with that, and now I'm using a H pattern with a splitter. The only reason I do that is I have a standard 6-speed manual transmission, so I would do like a splitter, or what the other one is, I think it's like a branch type style of transmission. I would only do that if I had enough gears, like if I had that one's called range. I remember that's called range. I'd only do that if I had the appropriate shifter for this game, which nobody seems to make the appropriate shifter right away, right off the bat, so. So, I mean, I'm real curious as to what you guys, you know, those of you who watch me, who know my situation, what are your guys' feelings about Auto, the self-driving truck? I keep calling it Auto. It's not a sentient being. It's just a self-driving truck. It's an autonomous vehicle. I think you guys understand how I feel. It's just something that, you know, again, I stress this a lot. Truck driving is something that I've always dreamed about doing. And so far, it's only been in my dreams. It's never been a reality for me. There hasn't been any possibility, really, for me to get a CDL. But you never know what the future holds. As much as I wish I knew what the future held, I don't. A little bit better at downshifting, but remember, guys, this is a different truck from what I'm used to driving. I like spicing it up a bit. I like driving different trucks every once in a while. made $2,000 because my driver just brought in some more money. It's awesome. I'm going a little bit faster than I should. Looking at the GPS, I need to go straight. We have about 2 hours, 27 minutes left on this haul. I didn't need to sleep. I didn't need to fuel up. And guys, honestly, I think this is the next truck I would buy for the company. Because, I mean, it's just, it's cruising so smoothly right now. I mean, this bad boy right here, this is what I meant by Peterbilt's cruise smoothly. Like, I feel I could probably do about 80 in this truck and not even feel it. Now that Freightliner and the Western Star, yeah, doing 80 in those trucks, you notice the truck starts to swerve every which way. Like, this is mostly because I don't have my hands perfectly on the steering wheel and I'm not perfectly steering. Downshift. There we go. Seven low, let's do sixth high. There we go. You know, sometimes with me and driving, it's hard finding gears. But mostly I'm looking out. I'm kind of programmed into where my shifter falls. So mostly I'm looking out at the street, and then I'm looking at the tachometer, and then sometimes I'm looking at where my gearing is. And by that I mean in the center of my dash, if you guys can see that, it says what gear I'm in. So sometimes I'm looking at that, sometimes I'm looking at the street. And then most of the time I'm looking at the street and listening to the truck, seeing how much it's cruising at, and then I'll look at the tachometer for a few seconds. But again, with an automatic truck, we wouldn't really need, at that point, you really wouldn't need to know how to shift. You wouldn't need a lot of things, actually. And this is what a lot of people are afraid of. You wouldn't need a driver. So pretty soon the trucking industry is going to be nothing but a bunch of rich people who can afford these trucks, which is not great. But still, my prediction is, and I don't know how true this is, it would cause car accidents involving semi-trucks to go down. You know, it would cause a decrease in semi-truck related accidents. And I've been listening to news a lot lately. It seems like every morning before I go to school, there's always a truck accident. Now I watch the Philadelphia news because I live in Delaware, and there's no local news, but all the times, every time in the morning, there's always like traffic accidents, always involving a semi-truck. So, go figure. Maybe this is why a lot of people are trying to come up with a way to put less human interaction on the road. But, I mean, you know, also, I don't look at driving for me right now as a getting from point A to point B. I see it more as something as entertainment. You know, some people watch TV for fun, some people play video games for fun. I'm one of those people who plays video games for fun. Some people do Hot Wheels cars, as you guys know. I'm one of those people. Some people write for fun. But me, you know, I mostly see driving as kind of another source of entertainment. It'd be great for me, I'd be fully independent if I could drive, and it'd also get me out of a lot of, you know, situations where I'm spending about half an hour or more waiting for somebody to come pick me up. If I could just hop in a car, I'd be in that mad rush of traffic and wouldn't have to wait as long, but I'm not complaining. For what it is right now, it's an okay system. It's a little broken, but needs to get better. engine brake time. And we're here. Enter. I believe this is the same carton of machine parts that I had before. Alright, let me see where I gotta go take this. Oh, okay, right over here. Aha. Let's use a mirror and check to see how far that trailer's kicking out. Yep, stuck. Might be best just to, might actually be best just to come around here. Like so. There we go. And possibly back this bad boy in. Now, I don't like backing these guys in because, as you can tell, I'm not too good at placing them. I don't use the mirrors too much for backing trailers in. So. Well, I'm still in reverse. How'd I get so cockeyed over here? How'd I get so crooked? Alright, trailer's actually in my mirror. That's not good. Almost jackknifing this bad boy. You know what? I might have them park this for me. Yeah, close enough. Alright guys, that's me talking about the self-driving truck for Truck and Talk Thursday. I hope you guys like this video. As always, comment, like, if you haven't already done this so far, subscribe. If you're finding my channel, you know, hope you guys are enjoying what I'm doing. See you in the next one. Next segment's Freightliner Friday, that'll be tomorrow. If you're watching this when it's scheduled. Otherwise, you know, keep checking out my channel. There's more truck related. There's more truck driving on there. There's car customization on there. If you're new to my channel, stick around. You'll see plenty of good stuff. Later.